Thank you for joining this webinar. So we are pleased to do this webinar with you today and share with you the last news of CSDR close to the go live of CSDR, which will start for the penalties management on the 1st of February, next 1st of February. So first of all, let's wish you a happy new 2022 years. I will make just a short roundtable to introduce all people who will attend, who will manage this webinar. So there is Sylvie Bonduel for Market Advisory, Jean-Christophe Cuinet for Business Expertise, Pascal Bilbao for Customer Relationship, and myself, so Arnaud Richenbus, as CSDR Project Management of this project for SGSS. So during this webinar, you will be able to ask questions through the chat, and we will answer to the question at the end of this session. So do not hesitate to ask your question during the presentation, and we will take around 20 minutes, if I'm not wrong, Jean-Christophe, to answer to the question. And if we can't answer to all the questions, we will take all the questions and we will answer by email if we are not able to answer to all the questions. So this webinar is a generic presentation of the features that we have implemented at SGSS level for the penalties management. May you need additional information, feel free to contact your usual customer relationship contact. And if necessary, we will be able to arrange a dedicated session for your specific question. To start, and after I give the floor to Sylvie, I just want to share some main figures because I think it's important to introduce what is the penalties management at SGSS level. And I think it's important for you to have these figures in mind. This is just to say that you should have in mind that the number of penalties per day for SGSS, it's around 700 penalties for all the clients of SGSS. So this means that maybe by chance, you will not have daily penalties and you can get you can have only a few penalties in a month. It's possible because the number is not so huge because you will see it is linked to the settlement failed activities, especially late matching and settlement failed. So sometimes we have seen that some of our clients can see that they have no penalties in amounts. It's possible. The other important thing I think to have in mind is that globally, what we see in terms of behavior of penalties at SGSS level is that the global net amount of penalties for a month is crediting. So this means that mainly it's a credit. It's not a global trend, but what we see based on our analysis of projective analysis and what we have seen during the dry run is that globally, we see that the position, the global net amount of amounts for client is a credit position. So it can be quite good things to know that it is crediting. That was I think the first information that I would like to share with you. And after we will go deeper and present the different features that will allow you to see how to follow your penalties. Excuse me. During this webinar, so we will see two main things. First thing, it is to make a focus on the last news of the regulatory news, and then after, as I said, we will present all the features that will allow you to follow your penalties. I will let the floor to Sylvie Bonduel to give you the last news of the regulatory news.
Thanks, Arnaud, and happy New Year to all of you. For sure, the main topic for the moment are penalties. However, I'd like to give you a quick update on another part of the settlement discipline regime, in the mandatory buy-in and its postponement. To clearly understand what is currently happening, you need to know, to keep in mind that the CSDR, the current CSDR, imposes a single date for all the settlement discipline regime. So the first action that was to amend CSDR so that there might be two different dates. But the EU legislative process is a long one, too long given the time constraints. So the European Commission decided to use a text which was in its final steps before adoption, and to include in this text an amendment of CSDR. The one that has been chosen was the DLT pilot regime regulation. And end of November last year, the three bodies, the European Commission, the Parliament, and the Council reached an agreement on the DLT pilot regime regulation, including the amendment of CSDR. So now this regulation has to be adopted, officially adopted, and its entry into force is expected in March. And it will be, of course, the same for the change of CSDR. And at that time, and not before, ESMA will be in position to propose a new date for the mandatory buy-in. This should be done, as usual, via a draft RTS. And then, again, we will have to deal with the legislative process, meaning that this draft RTS will have to be adopted by the European Commission. We can imagine that it will be done very quickly, but after that, there will be a 3 months non-objection period given to the European Parliament and the Council. So at the end, the new dates for the mandatory buy-in should be official around June. We don't know so far what will be the new date. We think the postponement should be around 2 years, at least 2 years. We expect a 3 years one. The important point is to is this gray zone that will exist between the 1st of Feb with the entry into force of the current settlement discipline regime and this point somewhere in June. And that's the reason why the ESMA wrote a letter to the national competent authorities in December, last December, are requesting these national competent authorities to not focus their supervisory task on the correct application of the mandatory buy-in regime. And something that should be noted and that has been very welcomed was the IMF, the quick IMF answer, saying that they intend to follow ESMA recommendation. Another point that I wanted to speak about is something that is what is currently ongoing in parallel with all this discussion is the CSDR review. CSDR is quite an old text, so the review, the process of its review has started actually in 2020. Last year, in July last year, the European Commission published a document listing 6 areas where there might be changes on CSDR, and one of these topics was the mandatory buy-in regime. So now we wait for the European Commission proposal. We thought it would be published end of 2021 or early 2022. Now it's more about April, and at that time we will know what will be the new buy-in regime. Well, that's it for me, and I leave the floor to penalties.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
So first, before I introduce and show you. Follow your penalties. Just want to highlight two things may be already known, but we think that it's important to start with this, is that you must know that there will be two main processes to follow for the penalties management, what we call the daily process and the monthly process, because it's not the same timing. And you will see that there will be different flow to manage and different information to manage at each process. So for the daily process, it's quite logic. The principle is that CSD and ICSD are responsible for the calculation and the reporting of penalties and provide this information to their participants. So SGSS, as a participant, will receive on a daily basis the penalties calculated by T2S and shared by the CSD and ICSD. Based on this reception, we try to match these penalties with our settlement instruction form and settlement instruction information in our book, and we enrich with this information to be able to provide you your list of penalties through different media that we will present you during this webinar. So this is for the daily process. And there is also a monthly process, which starts on the 14th business day after the previous month, on which so we receive also a flow on MT537, given us the global net amount that you will have to pay or receive. And so we receive this message, we make a reconciliation, and we provide to you this monthly advice to prepare the payment that will occur on the 17th of the business day following the previous month. So all the scheduling and all the content, all the elements describing the different type of flows, so daily and monthly, are described in major document that we want also to highlight. So which are the XDA framework and the Q&A from ESMA. And so all the development that have been done by SGSS follow this principle of XDA framework and the Q&A of ESMA. Globally, what you have to retain is that the SGSS offers in terms of services is divided in three axes, which is quite logical: to prevent the penalties, to manage the penalties, and to monitor the penalties. And you will see that all the services that we have developed are in line with these three axes of offer. To highlight, for example, for the prevention of settlement penalties with settlement discipline regime, it's not a new topic, and there is a lot of practice and habit that are already in place in our legacy system, in our legacy practice, and they will for sure allow to reduce the risk of penalties. So the first one is to give you on your settlement activities and your settlement instruction an accurate and timely status of updates, meaning that, as you know already, we send you as soon as we receive it, the MT548, giving you the status of your settlement instruction. The other legacy option is to allow you to follow your settlement activities, and you will see that we have exactly duplicate this approach on the penalties management that we have on the settlement activities, meaning that you will retrieve in SG Markets all the features that allow you to follow your penalties. So you will retrieve dashboard to see your penalties, capacity to export data, and especially export your penalty list. And you can also subscribe to specific report if you want to receive your penalties in an Excel or CSV file in a push mode. But we will describe this more deeply just after. You have also, in terms of mitigation of risk, the ability to request cancellation of your instruction, which is something which already exists, but we can allow you to avoid penalties. And also, for sure, since the beginning of this project and the the settlement discipline regime, we, as all the actors of the market, enhance of settlement of our practice. So we have made a lot of quantitative analysis and business analysis, all business monitoring, to improve our SSI quality and to improve our practice to be able to reduce the risk of late matching and settlement failed. With the settlement discipline regime, we have also enhanced new features because, as you know, since beginning of October, we have put as a default setup the partial settlement, because partial settlement become the practice, the common practice, whereas previously it was an optional practice. Now it is the default practice to be able to make partial settlement. And we will also make a focus on this in the setups that will be present by Pascal Bilbao at the end of this meeting. Just one thing we want also to highlight is that to get partial settlement, it is a combination of three level. So meaning that to get a partial settlement, this means that on your side, client side, you must authorize to get a partial settlement. The market should be able to manage it, meaning the CSD or the subcustodian, because we know that there is some market on which partial settlement will not be activated. And also, your counterparty must have also put as a possibility to make a partial settlement. So this means that if all the three levels are not aligned, partial settlement will not occur. Another thing important also to say is that you, even if it is the default behavior, you are able to maintain to not activate the partial settlement. And so this means that if the market is able to manage partial settlement, and if the counterparty has put the partial settlement indicator, but you have not authorized it, there will be no partial settlement. Another facilities that should decrease the risk of penalties, and especially the amount of penalty, is hold and release. And for this, we intend to be able to offer these features in the second semester of 2022. We also are working on a new possibility to alert in terms of risk of penalties. And for this, I think we will be able to deliver these features in Q2 2022. This was for the prevention of penalties. Now for the management of and the monitoring of penalties. So we have developed a reporting. You will see that there is some default reporting. The default reporting is the capability to see your penalties in SG market as you are for following your settlement instruction. And there is also additional reporting with two types of media. The first one is through Swift network. So you are able to subscribe to Swift reporting through MT537. So as I explained, the daily one and the monthly one. And you can also subscribe to another reporting, which is a file reporting. And you, for this, you have to do your own setup in SG market. And we will explain how you will be able to do it. After the next part, so linked to the monthly reporting, as I said, so you have the daily process with the reporting and the monthly also with the reporting. And there is a payment phase, which occurs, as I said, on the 70th business day after the end of the previous month. And for this, you can also choose on which account you want to be debited or credited of your penalty. And this will also be explained by Pascal Bilbao for the setup of this account. And for the payment also, you can choose in which currency you want to have your penalties if you want to apply a specific standing instruction. Now I propose to move to the first default capability to follow your penalties. So as I said, it will be in SG market. So as you have your settlement instruction dashboard, so here in securities, you will have a new menu allow you to follow your CSDR penalties. For the moment, it is a dedicated menu, and we are working, I think, in a few weeks, maybe, it will move to the securities module also. So there will be directly accessible through the securities module. For the moment, you have a dedicated module, which is CSDR penalties. When you click on this CSDR penalties menu, you have a submenu that will allow you to reach this screen with what we call the penalty list. And in this penalty list screen, you retrieve all the important information that we receive in the penalty message from the market, in the penalty part, and which we enrich with the settlement instruction information. So it's quite, let's say, simple. When you connect, you see the penalty of the day. So here it was done on the 7th of December, and I can see that I have all these penalties assigned to me. And you retrieve the reference of the penalties, the amount of penalty with the sign, if it is a debit or a credit, the currency of the penalty date, and the status. So as clients, there is only three status which are active, removed, and paid. And after, you retrieve all the information linked to your instruction and to the penalty. You can retrieve your instruction reference, the reference instruction which are in our book, your securities account, the cash account that will be used for the penalties, the depository on which the settlement failed occurred, the counterparty, the type of penalty, if it is a settlement failed or a late matching failed penalties, and the market reference, meaning the T2S reference. And sometimes you have the reason of the failed. So an important thing also to say is that all the information that we give on the penalties are the information that we receive from the market. So all what you see in terms of information on penalties are the information that we have received from the market, meaning that there is no calculation done at AGSS side. So all the calculations are done on market side, and we, let's say, just push the information that we receive. The only information that we enrich are regarding client reference and client information of the settlement instruction. Oops, sorry. After, I just show you if you want to go to see more details of the penalties, you can click on the loop and on the plus, and you can see the details of the penalties. So here it's an example. You will have a timeline of your settlement instruction and additional information regarding the penalties. And as I said, all this information are provided by the market, and some are enriched, especially for our treatment. So each time you see it, it will be assigned to the client. Meaning also, because I think it can be a question, if there is an issue at SGSS side, you will not see the penalty, it will be assigned to SGSS. For example, if you have sent the instruction in due time regarding your cutoff, and if there is an issue, maybe an IT issue on our side, and the instruction is sent late, in that case, the penalty will be assigned to SGSS, and you will not see it. After you retrieve, as I said, the main information, the penalty date, the amount, the type of penalty, the counterparty, the party BIC, and all the reference. You will also see some client information. So for example, here it was for our entity in Italy. And you can retrieve your information of securities account and penalty account. You have the amount calculation data, as I said, provided by the market. And you will retrieve also details on your market instruction and client instruction. Here it's an example of LMFP with a detail of each day calculation. So once again, this is what we have seen during the dry run. Sometimes we don't have all the details. So even if we have, let's say, a 7 days late matching fail penalties, sometimes we don't have all the 7 days, but we give what we receive from the market. Here, it's if I want to have additional information regarding market reference, if I click on the information button, I will get additional information regarding the market reference. Next feature is regarding the export. So on the list screen, you are able to make an XLS export. So this XLS export at this stage will give you the same information as we have on the screen. It was a remark on a previous webinar. We are working on the possibility to add the ISIN code. For the moment, I don't know when it will be delivered, but we have enriched already some information, especially for the webinar. We have not put the data, but if you connect to SG Market and make your own export, you will see that now you have the client name, so meaning the name of the securities account is in the list now. Here it's an example of the XLS. So after, based on this XLS, you can do your own graph or analysis. It can be useful to use an XLS to make some analysis out of SG Market. For example, here it's an example showing the balance between credit and debit, the number of penalties per day, and the amount. So what we have seen, as I just said before, is that debit and credit follow the same shape often, and it's quite true for all our clients. And we see that the debit is slightly higher than the debit. The next feature that we have also in SG Market, it is the global cash view. So just if I want to make a parallel with what we have in terms of media of communication, all this screen, in fact, it is a way to give you the information that we receive from the MT537. So for penalties views, it will correspond to the MT537 daily message, and for the global cash view, it corresponds to the MT537 monthly message. The advantage of this global cash view is that you can see it during the month, whereas for the MT537 monthly message, we receive it only on the 14th business day after the previous month. So this is an advantage, should I say, that during the month, you can see the cash forecast of your penalties position. Meaning, for example, I can see for the payments of December, I was on the 7th of December, but I can see the amount of the current months without waiting for the monthly reporting, which will occur only on the 14th business day of the next month. So and you retrieve a balance. So it's a balance per currency, per counterparty, and for your cash account. So here in the example, you can see that we have a global net amount of 3,570.61 euro penalties, and it's composed of 51 penalties. And after, if you want, you can have the details of the 51 penalties that compose this balance. Here is the example of the extraction. So you will retrieve the details of the penalties composing the net amount. Next possibility. So for the moment, we have presented the default reporting, which are for SG Market, but you can also make a customization to be able to receive a CSV or an XLS report in push mode. So in terms of reporting, there is two ways to receive in push mode. You can subscribe to MT537, and Pascal Bilbo will explain you how to subscribe to MT537 through Swift Network. And you can also subscribe to file report. For the file report, you have to do it by your own in SG Market in the schedule report module. In the schedule report module, there is already a lot of reports for settlement activities, but also for corporate action, for tax. And now we have added two new reports, one for the daily CSDR penalties report and one for the monthly CSDR penalties report. So, and I will show you how you can subscribe to this report. So you go to the schedule report, and then you click on a new report. You will have to choose the type of report. So CSDR daily report or CSDR monthly report. You can give a name to your report. And after, you have to choose the account of the report. For the moment, it's only possible to set up account by account. We are not able to make a group as we do for other reports. It is a limitation due to CSDR, but for the moment, it's only possible to do a report by account. After, you have to schedule the frequency. So for a daily, it will be daily. And the advice that we give is to put at 6 p.m. To receive this report. And I will explain why. It's because we receive penalties market all along the day. And we will make a focus on this. Just why the advice is to receive it at 6 p.m. and not before. Also choose to receive earlier, but the risk is that you will not have the complete day. It's also possible to set up several penalty reports within a day. But in that case, what you have to know is that this report, the file report, is an incremental report, which is not the case for the Swift report. The Swift report is in what we call delta mode, so meaning that you have only the new penalties. Let me take an example to explain this. For example, it is 2 p.m. in the afternoon, and you set up two file reports, one at 2 and one at 4 p.m. At 2 p.m., I have received penalty 1, 2, 3, and at 3 o'clock, for example, I receive penalty 4, 5, 6. If in the Swift report, I will receive in the first Swift report 1, 2, 3, and in the second Swift report 4, 5, 6. Whereas in the file report, at 2 o'clock I will receive 1, 2, 3, and at 4 o'clock I will receive 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this is an incremental report and not a delta report. So it's just to be known, because in terms of treatment, it can be different. So here is just a screen to show you you can customize the email title, the recipient of the file report. You can choose the language of the email and the type of file that you want to receive. It can be a CSV, an XLS, or a PDF file. Here, I just want to show you the content of the file report. So, coming back to the list screen. So here you have a list of 12 penalties. After I show you the type of emails that you can receive. So for on the first one, meaning that you have penalties. So you have a link to allow you to download the file report. And in the second email, it is when there is no penalties for your subscription. Hereafter, it is an example of the XLS file. So you will retrieve the same information that you have in SG Market in an XLS sent through email. So you retrieve the penalty date, the penalty reference, and the type of penalties, the amount of penalties, all the relevant information to allow you to manage your penalties. Here, I just want to make a focus just want to be sure. Do you see my screen? Do you see the presentation?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, sorry for this interruption. So just want to make a focus on why we advise to make a daily reporting in file report at 6 o'clock. Just to give you here some figures of when we receive penalties from the market. So for this, there is several batch within the day. Within the day, so that's why we have made some study. For example, I have put some figures up for the months of from the 20th of December to the 6th of January. You can see that all along the day we receive penalties, and we feel that at 6 p.m. you have a good views more than 80% of the days. In terms of penalty. For the moment, on AGSS side for Swift message, so there is three vacation, one at 2, one at 4, and one at 11 p.m. We are studying if we have to move the batch of 11 p.m. to 6 p.m. or to add another batch. So it's under discussion. The idea is to see when is the best time to give you the penalties for the day. So once again, our approach today is to say if you make a file reporting at 6 o'clock, normally you will have more than 80% of penalties of the day. That's why we advise this. One thing I would like also to share with you, it is the market status. So just to tell you, excuse me. Yes, regarding the market status of the dry run. So you know that the dry run has started since mid of September. It was the 14th of September. Nevertheless, when we have done the last webinar, as you can see, there was several sub-questions, several markets that were not ready. Now it's better, even if we have not received all sample of daily MT47, but definitely we see that we have more markets that are ready to send MT537. For example, on AGSS side, we were able to integrate EASY's penalties starting from the 8th of November, and Euroclear Bank, it was last week since the 6th of January. So now we have, let's say, more than 80% of the market scope, which is covered. And you will see, and we have seen that the number of penalties, as I said in the beginning of the presentation, is around 700 penalties per day. So we feel that we are on the target in terms of reporting for the daily reporting. To be also honest, it's still some question regarding the monthly process, because as you know, there was several difficulties on T2S and on CSD side. So by chain, we don't get the chance to make a full exercise for the monthly process. So we expect that the next one will be on the 20th of January. We'll be able to perform a full exercise of the monthly process. This was, I think, the main information regarding the reporting part. So just to introduce the parametrization and the setup part. Just as I said in the beginning of the presentation, so since beginning of October, we have activated by default the partial settlement. So you will see that we will request from you to give your position regarding these features if you want to have by default also the partial settlement. And for the penalty management, you will have also to specify which type of reporting do you want to subscribe, if you want a Swift reporting or a CSV reporting. And also, you will have to decide regarding the booking of penalties. So meaning if you want, which account you want to apply for your penalties and which currency. That's all for the features. I will let the floor now to Pascal to explain how you can set up and parameterize your choice regarding the settlement discipline regime management. Pascal.
It's my turn. Thank you so much, Arnaud. Good afternoon, everyone. If you can please show the Excel file. Thank you so much. So coming back in July 2021, after having sent the first CSDR communications to our clients, my colleagues and I here in Paris contacted our clients and sent to our clients this Excel file in order to know their decisions, their options concerning the settings that HSS propose, the CSDR settings proposed to our clients. Just an important point concerning if there are some delegated asset management asset managers online, we send this file to the head asset management companies in charge for these asset management companies to get in touch with their delegated asset managers. So please get in touch with them in order to know what were their decisions concerning the settings that we applied to the safekeeping account. So in this file, three types to complete. So for English speakers, the first ones related to the client and securities accounts, which will which is a description of the client's name, contacts and accounts. And the second tab is related to a generic rule. So generic rule, if you can show this second tab, Arnaud. The settings that we will apply on your behalf and at your request on the list of accounts, security accounts that you will have to complete in the previous tab. And the third tab for some exceptions to this generic rule, so exceptions that you would decide to apply to one or two of your security accounts, exceptions to the generic rules that you will apply to the rest and the major list of your security accounts. So on the in this file, you can see at the top of the tab some examples of the different options proposed by HSS. So three main settings. The first one related to the partial settlement. So Arnaud explained that we started to send this file beginning of July, but the 4th of October, we set up all the accounts with the partial settlement, at the exception of some of our accounts who requested to postpone this setup and to delay the partial settlement and wait for most of them, I suppose, the beginning of February. And the second solution proposed by HSS and to complete in this file is related to the reportings. Again, Arnaud explains that You've got two solutions, one for receiving some MT537 penalties messages, and the other ones with CSV files that you can extract and schedule by yourself on your HTMarket web portal. Okay, so CSV daily, monthly, and MT537 daily, monthly in the same manner. So that's for the reportings. And the third and main settings that we ask our clients to respond is related to the booking of the penalties. So four options, one by default, if you don't reply to us and complete this file, the penalties will be counted, booked on the cash account related, associated to your security account. That's the first option. And in the currency of your transactions, if you've got some transaction in US dollar and one US dollar account, penalties will be charged on your US dollar cash account. The second option that we propose in terms of booking is still on the your existing safekeeping account to cover the penalties on the 17th calendar days post months in a base currency, basically euro, if you've got a euro account, which is the standard, but you can also decide to convert all of your penalties in your US dollar cash account. The third option is to apply the penalties in a different account, basically an account in the name of the asset management company. In this case, same thing, two options. We can convert the penalties in the base currency or in a certain currency, or you can decide to book the penalties in the trade currencies, the currencies of your transactions in each of your cash account opened in these different currencies. So that's the objective of these different settings that we propose to our clients. Again, partial settlement, this has been set up at the exception of some clients. In terms of reportings, you have the possibility to set up by yourself on HTMarket the CSV files. If you want us to schedule and set up some Swift reportings, please complete this file, and the same for the booking of the penalties. Otherwise, if we don't have any reply from yourself, we will exercise the options by default, in this case, settlement currency, usual account. The first tab is, the same informations in the exceptions. You can decide to set up for, let's say, 9 of your accounts, a generic rule with by default the settlement currency and usual account. And for one remaining account, you can decide to schedule and ask us to convert the penalties in a base currency account, as an example. I hope having explained as much as possible the objective of this file. So it's not too late to complete this file. Please come back to us, and we are all at your disposal to resend this file and answer to your different questions. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Pascal. So maybe as we have I don't know if we have questions. Otherwise, I will make a focus also on the help center and add additional information. Jean-Christophe, do we have questions? Or maybe shall I explain the help center features?
Oh, you can explain the help center features. Okay. We have no questions for the moment.
Okay, so let me go back because I have skipped this part. You can have also in SG Market, there is a help center features when there is a quotation mark in the screen. Let me show you maybe on a previous screen. You have a quotation mark. If you click on it in the CSDR penalties module, you will have also a Q&A and some main question. So we try to put in this help center all the questions that we have also shared during the project in the Q&A. And it can be useful for you to if you have a question regarding the penalty status, the penalty payment, some question on to understand what is the status. You will retrieve the answer in this help center, and there will be also a tutorial with a video explaining the SG Market CSDR penalties module. And you retrieve also in this module all the relevant links. So as we said during this webinar, the link to the XDA framework and to the ESMA Q&A, which are for the main document that you should read carefully to understand the penalties mechanism. So in this help center, you normally retrieve all the questions, all the answer to your question in terms of penalties management. Last thing maybe that we can share with you to be complete. We have put some figures. It's just to say that from our point of view now, since let's say beginning of January now, we are in full dry run mode. So this means that you can consider that you have the closest view of the production of 1st February. All the penalties are sent by the market that are live. And if you want to fill and to evaluate the penalties management, you can now check on a day-to-day basis your penalties in SG Market or in the SWIFT that you will receive if you have subscribed to the SWIFT report or to the CSV report. We consider that now you have a good view of the production, of the trend of the production that will be live on the 1st of February 2022. I don't know if there is some question.
Question for the moment.
Just before we conclude, so we
have a question now.
Okay.
Will the presentation be shared? Arnaud, I think you can.
Yes. I don't know if Sylvie Chapelle is connected or someone from marketing, but I think yes. We share the support, the presentation. It will be shared.
Yes, absolutely. I confirm.
It's CET, Central Europe time. The report can be downloaded. I'm not sure to understand the question, but maybe when I read the question, I think I am not clear. The advice for the 6 p.m. CET, so Central Europe time, is for the file report that will be pushed for the download. If you want to use the export features of SG Market, so just show you where in the screen. If you want to export by your own, so in pool mode, so meaning that you have to connect to SG Market, you can do it all along the day. But once again, the advice is to do it at the end of the day due to the fact that we receive penalties from the market all along the day. And if you want to receive it in a push mode, so in a CSV or an XLS format in your email box, we advise effectively to set up it at 6 p.m. also. And it is a CET time, so Central Europe time. So maybe someone which is in Asia or somewhere else. I don't know if I have answered to the question. Can you confirm it if it's clear for Luli Reynald? Okay, thank you. And the question, maybe a question regarding the fees. I don't know who want to take this question. If we have Sylvie Chapelle connected or not. Otherwise, I will answer. Now, I will answer for the fees. So for the fees, we start to receive the business model from the different CSD and sub-custodian. For example, we receive the fees model of Euroclear Bank last week. So we are studying it. It's clear that there will be additional fees, and to be clear, for the moment we are working on our business model. At least we will populate and promote the cost of the market, and there will be additional fees due to the fact that we have developed services and features within SGSS. For the moment, I can't share the figures because we don't have them, because we still get the figures from the market, and now we work on these figures to be able to do our own model. But it's clear that there will be additional fees. Can you please share the contact name to range for the setup?
Pascal.
Ouais.
Yes, as I explained, the client service managers in Paris sent this file back in July 2021. So please get in touch with your client service manager in order to set up with him these different parameters and participate to the dry run. Until beginning of February. Hope having answered to your question. And I hope that you know your client service manager, of course.
Once again, this is for us, the advice is for sure to participate as soon as possible now, as we consider that it is very close to the production. If you know that you will use MT537, we advise you to set up it right now. I think all the participants and our competitor, to make it clear, I think they start to send their message by next week. I think by next week some competitors, I know that they will send MT537 as in production. So we have the same advice to say that as we consider that now dry run is stable for the monthly process. I should not say that for the monthly process, but for the monthly process, it is stable now. And if you want to test to see from a technical and from a functional perspective, what will occur on the 1st February, we should advise you to set up right now the type of media you want to use, starting from the 1st of February. And as Pascal said, use your usual contact to do the setup.
And the messages could be activated very, very shortly, within 2 days. If you've got, just a couple of accounts, that would be straightforward, and we could activate these very shortly.
So this is the end of this webinar. I don't know if there is additional question. Otherwise, we'll stop here for today. Thanks a lot for participating to this webinar, and hope you will have a easy launch for this new settlement discipline regime, and hope all the features that we have developed will help you as much as possible to be able to follow your penalties and your settlement activities. Thank you very much and have a nice day. Bye-bye.
Thanks to you. Oh, good afternoon.
Bye.